Welcome to Vani Current Affairs. Zero Discrimination Day, 1st of March. The Zero Discrimination Day is held every year on 1st of March. Zero Discrimination Day is an annual day celebrated by the United Nations and other international organizations. The day was first celebrated on 1st of March 2014 and was launched by UNAIDS Executive Director Michael Sidby on 27th of February of that year with a major event in Beijing. The day aims to promote equality before the law and in practice throughout all the member countries of the UN. The theme of Zero Discrimination Day 2021 is End Inequalities. Civil Account Day observed on 1st of March. The 45th Civil Account Day was celebrated at New Delhi. Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman was the chief guest of the event. The Comptroller and Auditor General Girish Chandra Murmu, Expenditure Secretary Dr. T.V. Somnathan and Comptroller Auditor General of Accounts Soma Roy Burman was present on the occasion among others. Jal Shakti Ministry announces 12 iconic sites for transforming them into Swachh tourist destination. Department of Drinking Water and Sanitation, Ministry of Jal Shakti has announced the selection of 12 iconic sites under phase 4 of Swachh iconic places. These sites include Ajanta Cave in Maharashtra, Sanchi Stupa in Madhya Pradesh, Kumbhalgarh Fort, Jaisalmer Fort and Ramdevra in Rajasthan, Golconda Fort in Telangana and Konark Sun Temple in Odisha, Chandigarh's Rock Garden and Jammu Kashmir's Dal Lake, Banke Bihari Temple in Mathura, Agra Fort in Uttar Pradesh and Kalighat Temple in West Bengal are the other sites. Russia launches first Arctic monitoring satellite. Russia has successfully launched its first satellite to monitor the Arctic's climate and environment. A Soyuz 2.1 carrier rocket with Arctica M satellite on board blasted off from the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan. The creation of the satellite system is highly elliptical orbit and necessary for information connection to the Operational Meteorology Department. The creation of satellite system is highly elliptical orbits is necessary for information collection to solve operational meteorology and hydrology problem and monitoring the climate and environment in the Arctic region. Pakistan to remain on FATF grey list. Global Money Laundering Watchdog, the Financial Action Task Force, decided to keep Pakistan on its terrorism financing grey list. The FATF said Islamabad should demonstrate effective implementation of targeted financial sanctions against all 1,267 and 1,373 designated terrorists. The FATF is an intergovernmental body set up in 1989 to combat money laundering, terror financing, and other related threats to international financial system. Currently, it has 39 members. Pakistan has been on the grey list since June 2018. India-Brazil will continue to work together in advance for space collaboration. The External Affairs Minister, Dr. S. Jaishankar, has congratulated Foreign Minister of Brazil, Ernesto Araújo, for successful launch of Amazonia 1 on ISRO's PSLV C-51 mission. Dr. Jaishankar said India and Brazil will continue to work for the advance over space collaboration. SBI General Insurance signed Bank Assurance Pact with IOB. The SBI General Insurance signed the SBI General Insurance and Indian Bank Overseas has signed a bank insurance agreement for distribution of non-life offering. Through the alliance, SBI General will offer a range of general insurance solutions and innovative products to IOB customers. Principal Scientific Advisor of GOI launched Swachhata Sarthi Fellowship, announcing the fellowship. Principal Scientific Advisor to the Government of India, Professor K. Vijay Raghavan, said India is a diverse cultural wonder with our practices and lifestyle being confronted by many environmental challenges. the Office of the Principal Scientific Advisor to the Government of India under its Waste to Wealth mission has launched the Swachhata Sarthi Fellowship to recognize students, community workers, or self-help groups. The self-help groups and municipal or sanitary workers who are engaged in tackling the enormous challenge of waste management scientifically and sustainably. The Waste to Wealth mission is one of the 9 national missions of Prime Minister's Science, Technology and Innovation Advisory Council, PMSTISC, targeted to encourage community participation. The Swachhata Sarthi Fellowships invites applications from students and community workers who have done previous work or are currently engaged in waste management activities, including awareness campaigns, surveys, and studies. There are 3 categories of awards under the fellowship. Category A is open to school students from 9 to 12 standards engaged in waste management community work. Category B is open to college student, UGPG research student that engaged in waste management community work. And category C is open to citizen working in the community and through self-help groups, municipality or sanitary workers who working beyond specification of their job requirement or DIONS. UN appointed Indian economist Ligia Noronha as Assistant Secretary General, United Nations Secretary General Antonio Guterres announced the appointment of Ligia Noronha of India as Assistant Secretary General and Head of New York Office of United Nations Environment Program. Noronha is an economist with over 30 years of international experience in the field of sustainable development. Economic Affairs Secretary gets additional charge of Department of Revenue. Secretary of Department of Economic Affairs, Tarun Bajaj, has given additional charge of Department of Revenue. He has been given additional charge after superannuation of Revenue Secretary Dr. Ajay Bhushan Pandey. Vice Admiral R. Hari Kumar takes oath as Western Naval Command Chief. Vice Admiral R. Hari Kumar took charge as the Flag Officer Commanding in Chief of Western Naval Command. Chadwick Boseman bags Golden Globe Award posthumously. Late actor Chadwick Boseman has been awarded the prestigious Golden Globe for Best Actor in a Motion Picture Drama. The actor won the Golden Globe posthumously for his performance as Levy in Ma Rainey's Black Bottom. The award was accepted by his late wife, Tyler Simon Ledward, on his behalf. Indian men's ski team wins bronze in ISSF World Cup. The Indian trio of Mairaj Ahmed Khan, Angad Veer Singh Bajwa, and Gurjoat Khangura won the bronze medal in men's ski team event at International Shooting Sport Federation Tournament, Shotgun World Cup in Cairo. The Indians defeated the Kazakhstan team of David Pochivalov, Edward Eschenko, and Alexander Mukhadiev at 6-2 in bronze medal match at third competition of International Shooting Sports Federation Tournament. Third Jan Aushadhi Divas celebration began on March 1st. The third Jan Aushadhi Divas celebrations began on March 1. The week-long celebration will go on till 7th of March. Jan Aushadhi Kendras conducted health checkups camps across the country. The health checkup activities include blood pressure, sugar level checkup, free doctor consultation, and free medicine distribution. Real-time monitoring system of toll plazas launched by Union Minister Nitin Gadkari, Union Minister for Road Transport and Highway, Nitin Gadkari launched the real-time monitoring system of toll plazas at a function in New Delhi. Speaking on the occasion, Mr. Gadkari said that implementation of FASTag at toll plazas has improved electronic toll collections and facilitated ease of doing business. He said it also saves time and fuel. The government has made FASTag mandatory for from 15th February midnight, and any vehicle not fitted with it will be charged double the toll at electronic toll plaza across the country. Sugamya Bharat app and handbook entitled Access the Photo Digest launched by Union Minister Thawar Chand Gehlot. Minister for Social Justice and Empowerment Thawar Chand Gehlot will virtually launch Sugamya Bharat app and a handbook entitled Access the Photo Digest. Sugamya Bharat app is a mean of sensitizing and enhancing accessibility. It provides for 5 main features, of which 4 are directly related to enhancing accessibility. PM Modi initiate Maritime India Summit 2021. Prime Minister Narendra Modi will inaugurate Maritime India Summit 2021 through video conferencing. The 3-day summit will held till 4th of March. The 3rd day Maritime India Summit 2021 is being organized by the Ministry of Ports, Shipping and Waterways on a virtual platform, Maritime India Summit. The summit will visualize a roadmap for India's maritime sector for next decade and will work to propel India to the forefront of global maritime sector. Eminent speakers from several countries are expected to attend the summit and explore the potential business opportunities and investment in India maritime domain. Denmark is the partner country for the 3-day long summit. Fino Payments Bank is now a scheduled bank. RBI has announced through a notification issued date 22 February 2021 that Fino Payment Bank has been included in the second schedule of RBI Act 1934. The scheduled commercial bank status allows Fino Payments Bank to enhance its banking position in the treasury and participation in LAF window as per the RBI. It also helped the bank strengthen its business proportion on liabilities generation. As a scheduled commercial bank, Fino Payments Bank will be better positioned to explore and manage government businesses. As a scheduled commercial bank, Fino Payments Bank will be better positioned to explore and manage government businesses, mandates pertaining to pension, provident funds, and various welfare schemes under direct benefit transfer will help enhance Fino's footprint in the financial inclusion space. Also increased visibility on the government website strengthens the customer's bond with the bank. Scheduled commercial bank in India are categorized into 5 groups based on their ownership nature of operation. These bank groups are State Bank of India and its associate, Nationalized Bank, Regional Banks, Regional Rural Banks, Foreign Banks, and other Indian scheduled commercial banks in private sector. SBI sponsored RRB's launch video KYC facility. Telangana Grameen Bank, Andhra Pradesh Grameen Bank, Vikas Bank becomes first RRBs in the country to adopt this tech that offers zero contact onboarding of customers at par with the commercial banks. The digital Insta saving account mobile app of Andhra Pradesh Grameen Vikas Bank and Telangana Grameen Bank was launched recently by State Bank of India Chairman Dinesh Kumar Khara. The app will be at the heart of digital Insta saving account launched by the 2 regional rural banks. The benefits of Disha include zero toll balance account can be opened within 10 minutes and activation of mobile banking and SMS alerts immediately. Bharat Petroleum Corporation Board approves sell of its 61.65% stake. Bharat Petroleum Corporation Board has approved sale of its 61.65% stake in Numaligarh Refinery for 9,600 crore rupees. Oil India Limited, Engineers India Limited and Assam government will be picking up the stake. The government has also received multiple expressions of interest for privatization of Shipping Corporation of India Limited. ISRO successfully launches Brazil's Amazonia 1 satellite along with 18 other passenger satellites. in the Indian Space Research Organization's ISRO first mission of the year, the country's polar rockets launches Brazilian satellite Amazonia 1 and 18 other satellites from Satish Dhawan Space Center in Andhra Pradesh, Sriharikota. The 18 core passenger satellites placed in the orbit include four from ISRO's Indian National Space Promotion and Authorization Centers and 14 from NSIL. After four stages of separation, the rocket launched Brazil's 637-kilogram Amazonia 1 satellite, its primary passenger. Amazonia 1 is the optical Earth observation satellite of National Institute for Space Research. The third edition of Rashtriya Sanskriti Mahotsav begins. The third and final edition of Rashtriya Sanskriti Mahotsav 2021 in West Bengal, organized by the Ministry of Culture, Government of India, began on 27 February 2021 at Murshidabad, West Bengal. The directors of all the zonal cultural centers of Ministry of Culture were present during the inauguration of the Mahotsav and lit the ceremonial lamp. Health Minister Harshvardhan inaugurates second edition of Global Bio India 2021. The Union Minister for Science and Technology, Earth and Science and Health and Family Welfare, Dr. Harshvardhan, inaugurated the second edition of Global Bio India 2021 in New Delhi through virtual mode. The three-day event will showcase the strength and opportunities of India's biotechnology sector at national level and to the global community. The three-day event, being held from 1st to 3rd March 2021, has been organized on a digital platform. The theme of this year is Transforming Lives, with the tagline Bioscience to Bioeconomy. Book title Advantage India, The Story of Indian Tennis by Anindya Datta. Anindya Datta has written the book entitled Advantage India, The Story of Indian Tennis. The book highlights the story of Indian tennis. Westland Sports publishes the book. PM Narendra Modi to receive CERAWeek Global Energy and Environment Leadership Award. Prime Minister Narendra Modi will receive the CERAWeek Global Energy and Environment Leadership Award this week in recognition of his commitment to sustainability in the energy and the environment. The theme of this day was, the theme was the new map, energy, climate, and charting the future. CERAWeek by IHS Markit, the world's preeminent energy conference, will be held virtually from March 1 to 5th. The year 2021 marked the 39th edition of conference and is the first time that it will be an all virtual event. Golden Globes 2021, complete list of winners. The Golden Globe 2021 ceremony was held on 1st of March, purpose to recognize excellence in film, both American and international, and American television. This was the 78th edition of annual event, which honored the best in American television as well as film in 2020 and early 2021, as chosen by the Hollywood Foreign Press Association American TV series. The Crown won the most award of the ceremony with four awards. Winner in the film category, Best Film, goes to drama Nomadland. Best Film, Musical Comedy, Borat Subsequent Movie Film. Best Director, Chul Chow for Nomadland. Best Actress Drama, Andra Day for The United States versus Billie Holiday. Best Actor Drama, Chadwick Boseman for Ma Rainey's Black Bottom. Best Actress Musical Comedy, Rosamund Pike for I Care a Lot. Best Actor Musical Comedy, Sacha Baron Cohen for Borat Subsequent Movie Film. Best Supporting Actress, Jodie Foster for Mauritian. Best Supporting Actor, Daniel Kaluuya for Judas and the Black Messiah. Best Screenplay, Aaron Sorkin for The Trial of the Chicago 7. Best Foreign Language Film, Minara. Best Animated Feature Film, Soul. Best Original Score, Soul. Best Original Song, Low Scene from Life Ahead, winner in the television category. Best TV Series Drama, The Crown. the best TV series, musical comedy, Schitt's Creek, best limited series, anthology or TV film, The Queen's Gambit, best actress drama, Emma Corrin for The Crown, best actor drama, Josh O'Connor for The Crown, best actress musical comedy, Catherine O'Hara for Schitt's Creek, best actor musical comedy, Jason Sudeikis for Ted Lasso, best supporting actress, Gillian Anderson for The Crown, best supporting actor, John Boyega for Small Axe, best actress limited series, anthology or TV film is Anya Taylor-Joy for Queen's Gambit, best actor Mark Ruffalo for I Know This Much Is True. Vinesh Phogat beats Vanessa Kalajdzinskaya to win gold in Ukraine wrestling event. India's star wrestler Vinesh Phogat defeated 2017 world champion V. Kalajdzinskaya to win the gold medal at the Outstanding Ukrainian Wrestler and Coaches Memorial Tournament. Haryana's Bhivani Best Vinesh won in the 53 kg bout with 10-8 lead. World Hearing Day 2021 celebrated on March 3rd. The world observed the World Hearing Day on March 3 every year. This year, the theme is Screen Rehabilitate, Communicate to address hearing loss and ear diseases across the life course. This day is observed to highlight and spread the message that timely and effective care can help people with hearing loss to achieve full potential. This occasion is to spread awareness about action that can be taken to protect the auditory nerves and adopt prevention measures. WHO commemorates World Hearing Day each year and decides the theme. World Wildlife Day 2021 was celebrated on World Wildlife Day 2021 celebrated on March 3rd. Wildlife Day 2021 on March 3rd. World Wildlife Day is observed annually on March 3rd to celebrate and raise awareness of the world's flora and fauna. This year, the theme for World Wildlife Day is Forest and Livelihood, Sustaining People and Planet. The day was proposed by Thailand and recognized in 2013 by United Nations General Assembly. India sending humanitarian assistance to drought-hit Madagascar. S. Jaishankar and India announced it will send a consignment of 1,000 metric tons of rice and 1 lakh tablets of hydrochloroquine to drought-hit Madagascar. The humanitarian assistance will be delivered on board the Indian naval ship Jalaswa. The ship will leave with food and medical assistance on 3rd of March and is expected to reach the port of Ehola in Madagascar between March 21 and 24. The Indian assistance was conveyed to the Madagascar government during External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar's phone call with his Madagascar counterpart, Tehindra Janarivelo Jacoba A.S. Olive. P.S. Modi to mark the inaugural session on Harnessing Education, Research and Skill Development for Atmanirbhar Bharat. Prime Minister Narendra Modi will address the inaugural session on Harnessing Education, Research and Skill Development for an Atmanirbhar Bharat. Education Minister Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank will address valedictory session. Education Minister releases study materials of Indian Knowledge Tradition courses of NIOS. Union Minister of Education Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank released the study material of Indian Knowledge Tradition courses of National Institute of Open Schooling in Noida, Uttar Pradesh. Mr. Pokhriyal said NIOS is already making efforts to spread the Indian knowledge tradition within the country and abroad. He informed Vedic studies, Sanskrit grammar, Indian philosophy, Sanskrit literature and Sanskrit language. Courses have been prepared for secondary and senior secondary level by NIOS. Lok Sabha TV and Rajya Sabha TV merged into one single entity, Sansad TV. The Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha television channels that broadcast the proceedings of the upper and lower house of parliament respectively have been merged into a single entity. Retired Indian Administrative Service officer Ravi Kapoor was appointed the Chief Executive Officer of Channel for 1 year on March 1st. The decision is in the line with the proposal of a panel headed by former Prasar Bharati Chairman A. Surya Prakash. The panel was set up by Rajya Sabha Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu after consulting with Speaker Om Birla in November 2019. Nagaland launches its first air cargo service from Dimapur Airport. Nagaland launches its first air cargo services from Dimapur. Chief Minister Nephew Rio officially flagged off the service, a joint initiative of Department of Horticulture, Nagaland and Airport Authority of India with Air India and IndiGo as airline partners. Cash-free partners with PayPal for global payment solution. Homegrown payment and banking technology company Cash-free announced its partnership with PayPal to enable international payments for merchants. Cash-free payment solution is a payment gateway. It can collect local and international payments with a simple integration. In the first Air Force to participate in Exercise Desert Flag 6 in UAE, the Indian Air Force IAF will participate in the Exercise Desert Flag 6 along with the Air Force of the UAE, the US, France, Saudi Arabia, South Korea and Bahrain for the first time. The exercise is scheduled from March 3rd to 21 at Al Dhafra Air Base in UAE. The Exercise Desert Flag is an annual multinational large force employment warfare exercise hosted by UAE Air Force. The IAF is participating for the first time in Exercise Desert Flag 6 along with an force of United Arab Emirates, United States of America, France, Saudi Arabia, South Korea and Bahrain. Hurun Global Reach List 2021. Mukesh Ambani, 8th richest in the world. Elon Musk at top Asia's richest person. And Reliance Industry Chairman Mukesh Ambani has been ranked 8th on the Hurun Global Reach List 2021. Mukesh Ambani's total wealth swelled to $83 billion, approximately ₹6.09 lakh crore, over the past 1 year. Tesla's chief Elon Musk bagged the top spot on the list for the first time after adding a massive dollar of $151 million during the year to take its net worth to $197 billion. Commercial incorporation boss Jeff Bezos ranked second with $189 billion in net worth. Bernard Arnault, chief executive of LVMH Moët Hennessy, the world's largest luxury goods company with a net worth of $114 billion, the Microsoft founder Bill Gates with $110 billion, and Facebook founder Mark Zuckerberg with $101 billion were among the top 5 billionaires. LJP's Jallikattu selected as Global Reel Award nomination. Lizzo Joss Pellicer's Jallikattu has been nominated for the prestigious Motion Picture Sound Director Golden Reel Award, which honor various categories in the entertainment sector. The film has been nominated for Outstanding Achievement in Sound Editing in the 86th edition of the awards. National Safety Day, 4th of March. National Safety Day is observed on March 4 every year to commemorate the foundation of National Safety Council. The aim is to raise awareness about safety measures that need to be undertaken to prevent accidents and mishaps. The objective of the day is to renew the commitment of employees and the general public to work safely and ensure the integration of safe and sound work culture and lifestyle. This year, the theme is Sadak Suraksha. National Security Day, 4th of March. On 4th of March, India is celebrated as National Security Day, Suraksha Divas, every year in honor of Indian security forces. The aim is to show gratitude to all the security forces, including policemen, paramilitary forces, commandos, guards, army officers, and other persons involved in security, who sacrificed their life in maintaining the peace and security of people of the country. Government Amends Insurance Ombudsman Rule 2017. Government on 2nd of March 2021 notified comprehensive amendments to the Insurance Ombudsman Rule 2017 with a view to improve the working of the Insurance Ombudsman mechanism to facilitate resolution of complaints regarding deficiencies in insurance service in a timely, cost-effective and impartial manner. The Ombudsman mechanism was administered by the Executive Council of Insurers, which has now been renamed as the Council for Insurance Ombudsman. Earlier, the scope of complaints to the Ombudsman was limited to only disputes, but now it has been enlarged to include the deficiencies in the service on the part of insurer, agents, brokers, and other intermediaries. 2023 declared as International Year of Millets as UN General Assembly. The UN General Assembly adopted by the consensus a resolution sponsored by India and supported by over 70 nations declaring 2023 as International Year of Millets. It aimed at raising awareness about the health benefits of grain and their sustainability for culture. The grains and their sustainability for cultivation under changing climatic conditions. The resolution titled International Year of Millets 2023 was initiated by India with Bangladesh, Kenya, Nepal, Nigeria, Russia, and Senegal, and was co-sponsored by over 70 nations. The 193-member General Assembly unanimously adopted the resolution declaring 2023 as the International Year of Millets. Separate cell for National Commission for Women. Commission in Ladakh, Jammu and Kashmir. Newly formed Ladakh and Jammu and Kashmir Union Territories will have a separate cell in National Commission for Women. The Commission's chairperson, Rekha Sharma, said that by the end of this month, separate cells for the new Union Territories will be created. SBI MF launches first overseas fund. The State Bank of India Mutual Funds has launched its first overseas offering on 1st of March 2021. The fund, entitled SBI International Assets US Equity FOF, is an open-ended fund of funds scheme investing in a mutual fund scheme that invests in US markets, which are domiciled overseas. The scheme will invest 95 to 100% of its net assets, generally in Amundi Fund's US Pioneer Fund, which invests predominantly in the US markets. Bharat Petroleum Corporation Board approves sale of its 61.65% stake in Numaligarh Refinery. Bharat Petroleum Corporation Board has approved sale of its 61.65% stake in Numaligarh Refinery for 9,875 crore rupees. Oil India Limited, Engineers India Limited, and Assam government will be picking up the stake. Government has also received multiple expressions of interest for privatization of Shipping Corporation of India Limited. India backs highest ever FDIs over $67 billion for first 9 months of current fiscal. India received the highest ever foreign direct investments of over $67 billion for the first 9 months of a financial year last year. During the period of April to December 2020, FDI equity inflow grew by 40% compared to corresponding period in the last financial year. As per Ministry of Commerce and Industry, these trends are an endorsement of India's status as a preferred investment designation among its global investors. Measures taken by the government on the front of policy reforms, investment facilitation, and ease of doing business have resulted in a tremendous FDI inflow into the country. Ease of living index, Bangalore and Shimla among the most livable cities across country. Minister for Housing and Urban Affairs Hardeep Singh Puri announced the release of final ranking of Ease of Living Index 2020 and the Municipal Performance Index 2020 in New Delhi in an online event. The ranking under Ease of Living Index 2020 were announced for the cities with a population of more than 1 million and cities with less than 1 million people. In all, 111 cities participated in the assessment exercise that was conducted last year. Bangalore emerged as the top performer in the million plus category, followed by Pune, Ahmedabad, Chennai, Surat, Navi Mumbai, Coimbatore, Vadodara, Indore, and Greater Mumbai. Kuldeep Singh takes additional charge as CRPF DG. IPS officer Kuldeep Singh has assumed the additional charge of CRPF Director General. The Ministry of Home Affairs has given Singh an additional charge of DG CRPF to Kuldeep, who is a 1986 batch officer from West Bengal cadre. Special DG CRPF Kuldeep Singh will look after the duties of General Director General CRPF and AAP Maheshwari, who retired. Mary Kom appointed as chairman of AIBA's Champions and Veterans Committee. Six-time world champion Mary Kom has been appointed as chairperson of the International Boxing Association Champions and Veteran Committee. The committee formed in December last year consists of most respected worldwide boxing veterans and champions who have achieved significant results and who are ready to share their experience. AIBA President Umar Kremlev said this is a letter to the 2012 Olympic bronze medalist. Mary Kom was elected by the board of directors of IABA. Bihari Puraskar 2020 to be awarded to Mohan Krishna Bohra. The 30th Bihari Puraskar for 2020 will be given to Mohan Krishna Bohra for his Hindi book of criticism entitled Taslima, Sangharsh or Satya. The KK Birla Foundation announced this in New Delhi. The book was published in 2016. Kohli becomes first cricketer to have 100 million followers on Instagram. India captain Virat Kohli has recorded another century, albeit for not on the pitch this time, as he became the first cricketer in the world to have 100 million of followers on social media platform Instagram. The 32-year-old Kohli is also the first person in the Asia-Pacific region to achieve the feat. Kohli is also the fourth most followed sports person on Instagram. Portugal football star Cristiano Ronaldo tops the chart with 265 million followers ahead of Argentina football captain and FC Barcelona legend Lionel Messi and Brazilian Neymar, who are second and third in the list with 186 million and 147 million followers respectively. SpaceX successfully tests Starship SN10 rocket. SpaceX successfully tested its Starship SN10 prototype rocket after two recent failed attempts. The rocket prototype was launched to an altitude of 10,000 kilometers and then landed back onto the ground. However, the rocket exploded over 6 minutes after landing. Bangladesh government launched national app portal. The government of Bangladesh has launched its national app portal, BangladeshApp.com. The agreement between the ICT division of the government of Bangladesh and telecom company Robi was signed in Dhaka. Through this agreement, Bangladesh apps will be established as the hub of the ICT division for application developers. Under the agreement, the ICT division will collaborate with the BD apps to organize exclusive boot campaigns and software development events in the country. Launching the app portal as the national app portal, ICT Minister Junaid Ahmed Palak said that app developers from any organization can use this platform to upload their apps. World Bank plans $100 million guarantee scheme for solar rooftop projects. The World Bank plans to introduce a $100 million credit guaranteed scheme to boost India's rooftop solar program. The scheme will allow micro, small and medium enterprises to avail concessional debt financing for setting up rooftop solar units. The World Bank scheme, along with the State Bank of India and the MSME Ministry to accelerate adoption of rooftop solar units with help of MSMEs, assess credit of around $1 million. The agreement will be beneficial for the firms that often do not meet the leading criteria of banks and other financial institutions, with their financial woes being exacerbated by the COVID-19 pandemic. PNB Housing Finance and Yes Bank signed strategic co-lending pact. PNB Housing Bank Finance said it has tied up with Yes Bank for a strategic co-lending service that will facilitate detailed house loans and competitive rate. The PNB Housing Finance said in the regulatory filing that PNB Housing and Yes Bank will synergize capabilities to provide an efficient and seamless experience of existing and new retail home loans customers. It added that this strategic co-lending agreement will offer convenient and customized retail loans to home buyers at competitive interest rates. India signs pact with Philippines for supply of BrahMos missile. India and the Philippines have signed a key agreement to facilitate government-to-government deal on military hardware, including the potential supply of BrahMos cruise missiles. The BrahMos missile is produced by an India-Russian joint venture, BrahMos Aerospace, and it can be launched from submarines, ship, aircraft, or from land platforms. The pact was signed by Undersecretary Raimundo Elefante of the Philippines Department of National Defense and Indian Ambassador Shambhu Kumaran at Camp Aguinaldo, headquarters of Filipino Armed Forces. It is the fastest supersonic cruise missile in the world. Manpreet Bora appointed India's High Commission to Australia. Senior diplomat Manpreet Bora has been appointed as India's next High Commissioner to Australia. The Ministry of External Affairs, Mr. Bora, a 1988 batch Indian Foreign Service officer, is presently Ambassador of India to Mexico. He is expected to take up the assignment shortly. Cricketer Rohit Sharma appointed as Brand Ambassador of Glenmark Pharma. Drug major Glen Pharma said it has been signed cricketer Rohit Sharma as brand ambassador for his product Candid Powder. The company said in a statement that Sharma has officially signed on to represent Glenmark's Candid Powder, a legacy brand of the company's consumer care division. QS World University ranking 12 Indian institutions on securing position in top 100. Union Minister Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank has congratulated 12 Indian Institute on securing a position in top 100 in the QS World University Rankings by Subjected 2021. These institutions are IIT Bombay, Delhi, Madras, Kharagpur, IISc Bangalore, Guwahati, Bangalore, Ahmedabad, IISc Bangalore, IIT Guwahati, IIM Bangalore, IIM Ahmedabad, JNU, Anna University, University of Delhi, and OP Jindal University. India commemorates Chabahar Day on 4th March 2021. India commemorated the Chabahar Day on March 4, 2021 on the sidelines of the Maritime India Summit 2021, which was held from March 2 to 4, 2021. The event was held virtually. Ministers from Afghanistan, Armenia, Iran, Kazakhstan, Russia, and Uzbekistan participated in the event. It is the only Iranian port with direct access to the Indian Ocean. An agreement was signed between India and Iran in 2018 for its development. EPFO board recommends an unchanged 8.5 interest on deposits from 2020 to 21. The Employees Provident Fund Organization has kept the interest rates unchanged on provident fund deposits at 8.5% for financial year 2020-21. This rate, the same was last year, is the lowest offered by EPFO in 8 years. There was speculation that the EPFO would lower interest on provident fund deposits for this fiscal year from 8.5% in 1920, owing the coronavirus induced slowdown through 2020. Dr. Harshavardhan launches CSIR Floriculture Mission. Dr. Harshavardhan encouraged scientists of CSIR laboratories across the country to develop the land available at each laboratory to set up as a model under CSIR Floriculture Mission. CSIR Floriculture Mission was been approved for implementation in 21 states and union territories of India, wherein available knowledge based in CSIR Institute will be utilized and leveraged to help Indian farmers and industry reposition itself to meet the import requirements. UN reports so close to 931 million tons of food were wasted globally in 2019. The Food Waste Index Report 2021, the UN National Environment Program and partner organization RAP said that around 931 million tons of food waste was generated in 2019, 61% which came from household, 26% from food service, and 13% from the retail. This suggests that 17% of the total global food production may be wasted. In India, the household food waste estimated to 50 kg per capita per year and 768 kg per capita per year or 68760163 tons a year. Sustainable Development Goal targeted 12.3 aims at halving per capita global food waste at the retail and consumer levels and reducing food losses along production and supply chains. One of the two indicators of the target is the Food Waste Index. Reliance Power forms JV with JERA for 745 megawatt project in Bangladesh. Anil Ambani-led Reliance Power has formed a joint venture with Japan headquartered JERA Corporation Incorporation to develop a new gas-fired power station project in Bangladesh. The company has achieved financial closure for the project with a group of lenders, including Japan Bank for International Cooperation and Asian Development Bank, and requisite condition for availing drawdown under the loan agreement have been achieved. The project is to build, own, and operate a 745 megawatt natural gas combined cycle power project in Meghna Ghat near Dhaka. The Federal Reserve Bank of New York appointed Indian origin Noreen Hassan as its first VP COO. An Indian origin veteran of the financial services industry has been appointed as the first vice president and chief operating officer of Federal Reserve Bank of New York. Noreen Hassan has been appointed by the board of directors of the Federal Reserve Bank of New York as the first vice president and chief operating officer effective from March 15. Bangladesh to confirm its highest civilian award. Swadhinta Puraskar. Bangladesh has announced the name of 9 individuals and 1 organization for confirming the independence award, the highest civilian award of Bangladesh for the year 2021. The Cabinet Department of the government issued a press release. 4 individuals have been selected posthumously for the award under the category of freedom fighters for their contribution to the liberation war of Bangladesh. This include AKM Bajlur Rahman, Ahanan Ulhan Master, Brigadier General Khurshid Uddin Ahmed, and Akharajuddin Chaudhary Babu. Dr. Marin Moni Guha Niyogi has been selected for his contribution to science and technology. Mahadev Shah will be honored with the award for literature, while Atur Rahman Ghazi Majrul Anwar will get the award for their contribution in the field of culture. Jammu and Kashmir top medals tally at Khelo India Winter National Game in Gulmarg. Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir topped the medals tally in the second edition of Khelo India Winter National Games. The day 5 mega sports event, which began on 26th of February, concluded in the famous ski resort of Gulmarg in North Kashmir's Baramulla district. Jammu and Kashmir won 11 gold, 18 silver and 5 bronze medals. The event was inaugurated by Prime Minister Narendra Modi. The event was organized by Union Minister of Youth Affairs and Sports in collaboration with the Jammu and Kashmir Sports Council and the Winter Games Association of Jammu and Kashmir. In the event, more than 1,000 athletes from 27 states and union territories took part. Women's trap team wins silver as India finishes year's first shotgun World Cup with two medals. India's women's trap team, trio of Kriti Gupta, Manisha Kheer and Rajeshwari Kumari, won the silver on the concluding day of year's first International Shooting Sports Federation World Cup shotgun in stage in Cairo, Egypt, going down 4-6 to Russia in the final. That's all for today's current affair bulletin. Thank you for watching. Namaskar.